So hello everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. In today's session guys, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 16th of July to 18th of July. Alright, so let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, let me tell you this, that if you want to have the PDF of this session with marked answer, you can go to the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. Alright, and now let's talk about the very first question. Very, very important question for the upcoming NABARD examination. So the question is, name the mascot launched by Department of Consumer Affairs for empowering consumers and generating awareness of their rights. Now, of course, Department of Consumer Affairs works under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, and this ministry is currently headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. This department has launched a mascot for awareness generation of the consumers, right? So this mascot guys, his name is Jagriti. What is the name of this mascot? It is Jagriti. Do you remember the name? Very, very important. Now this mascot is nothing but a mascot for empowering consumers and generating awareness about the consumer's right. Right? Iske alawa, this Jagriti will be projected as an empowered consumer. Right? This Jagriti, how this Jagriti will work by the way. So this Jagriti will, be projected as an empowered consumer who is spreading awareness about the consumer right and also who addresses solutions to the problem faced by the consumers. Jo bhi consumer problem face karta hai, usko ye address karne wala ek empowered citizen ki tarah isko project kiya jayega. Okay? And remember, this mascot will be used for generating awareness about various themes like Provisions of Consumer Protection Act of 2019, hallmarking, National Consumer Helpline toll-free number 91915 hai jo ki, Provisions of Weights and Measures Acts and other important provisions which are related to the consumer affairs. Okay, so that's it. Itna hi padna hai. Now let's come back to the question. The correct answer to this question is option B, Jagriti, because that is the name of the mascot launched by the Department of Consumer Affairs. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which says, which ministry's website has been ranked number 1 in the National E-Governance Service Delivery Assessment conducted by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances? Now you just have to tell the name of that ministry jiski website number 1 pe thi. So let's talk about this news. Remember, a National E-Governance Service Delivery Assessment was conducted by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances, which in short is DARPG, in collaboration with NASSCOM and KPMG. Right? NASSCOM and KPMG ke saath milke ye assessment kiya gaya tha. The objective of this assessment was to improve the effectiveness of states and UTs in the e-governance service delivery. Right? And it was based on 4 parameters, which are accessibility, content availability, ease of use and information security, and number 4 is privacy for central ministry portals. And as per this index, or Ministry of Home Affairs ke column mein bhi aaya hai abhi in PIB, that the website of Ministry of Home Affairs has been ranked number 1 under the central ministries portal, while under the category of central ministry services portal, there is a portal of Ministry of Home Affairs, which is Digital Police Portal, which has been ranked at number 2. Now, we are talking about only about the Ministry of Home Affairs because abhi PIB mein yahi aaya hai. I have the detailed index, but I am not going to discuss that because wo bahut zyada detailed index hai. That is not important for the exam. So, we will do those part from that index only, jo ki news mein aayega. Okay. So, abhi ke liye yeh hai news mein. So, website of Ministry of Home Affairs has been ranked number 1 in the Central Ministries Portal. While in the Central Ministry Services Portal, Digital Police Portal of Ministry of Home Affairs has been ranked number 2. Alright. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Ministry of Home Affairs, option C, headed by Mr. Amit Shah. Amit Shah, he is also the Minister of Cooperation and his Lok Sabha constituency is Gandhinagar, which is of course in Gujarat. Right. Moving ahead to question number 3. Very, very important question. Consider the following statements with respect to rankings given by National Institutions Ranking Framework. In short, NIRF ki rankings release ho gayi hai. And you have to identify the correct statement regarding these rankings. Right? So this is the 7th edition of NIRF ranking. Right? This is the 7th edition. The very first edition was launched in the year 2016. And the approval to this ranking was given in the year 2015 by the Union Cabinet. Now this index ranks only the higher educational institution in the country. जो हमारे देश के higher educational institution है उनको rank करता है in various different categories and in the overall category as well. And this index is based on 5 parameters with different weightages. Number 1, we have teaching, learning and resources with 30% weightage. Then we have research and professional practice, 30% weightage. Graduation outcomes, 20%. Outreach and inclusivity, 10%. And finally, perception ka bhi 10%. Right? Now, talking about the ranking. So, alag-alag category mein alag-alag toppers hai. So, overall, once again, it is IIT Madras. Last year also, it was IIT Madras. Among universities, it is IISc, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Colleges mein, once again, Miranda House of Delhi University. Last year also, it was at number 1. Research Institution, IISc, Bangalore. Engineering, of course, IIT Madras. Once again, Management, IIM, Ahmedabad. Pharmacy, once again, Jamia Hamdard, which is located in New Delhi. Medical mein, once again, it is AIIMS of New Delhi. Dental mein, there is a change. Last time, it was Manipal. This time it is Savita Institute of Medical and Technical Sciences of Chennai, right? Law mein, this time it is NLSUI of Bangalore. And in architecture, it is IIT Roorkee once again. All right, so these are the toppers from these categories. You have to remember all the winners, okay? Yes, you have to remember all the winners because examiner ka kuch nahi pata, wo in mein se kisi bhi category ka winner pooch sakta hai, all right? So now let's come back to the question. Among pharmacy colleges, Jamia Hamdard has been ranked number 1. Is that so? Yes. Among architecture institution, IIT Delhi is the topper. No, it's IIT Roorkee. So, second statement is incorrect. Alright. And among medical colleges, AIIMS New Delhi has been ranked number 1. Yes. So, 1 and 3 are correct, which means option C will be the correct answer, guys. Option C. Alright. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission? Now you must be wondering that why we are discussing about Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission. It was to launch in the year 2020 on 15th of August. Then why we are talking about this? So we are talking about this because the very first hackathon under the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission hackathon series has been launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Alright, so the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has organized the first hackathon under the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission Hackathon Series. And where this first hackathon has been organized? So it has been organized at Smart City Operation Center, which is located in Pune, Maharashtra. Theek hai? This is very important. Do remember this. Jo pehla hackathon hai, kahan pe hua hai? Pune mein hua hai. Iske baad ke jo hackathons honge, that is not required to remember, but yes. Since it is the very first hackathon, so you have to remember its location as well, okay? So the series of hackathon will encourage young talent in the country to contribute to the enhancement of the building blocks of digital health ecosystem of the country, alright? And this was organized in association with Pune Municipal Corporation and Pune Smart City Development Corporation Limited, okay? And now talking about Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, that is important because ये एग्जाम में आपसे पूछा जा सकता है. सो रिमेंबर, इट वाज लॉन्च्ड ऑन 15th ऑफ अगस्त 2020 एज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट इन 6 यूनियन टेरिटरीज. 6 यूनियन टेरिटरीज में उसको लॉन्च किया गया था. एंड दीज आर द 6 यूनियन टेरिटरीज, ठीक है? दीज आर अंडमान एंड निकोबार, चंडीगढ़, दादरा नागर हवेली एंड दमन एंड दीव, लद्दाख, लक्षद्वीप एंड पुडुचेरी. दीज वर द 6 पायलट प्रोजेक्ट्स वेयर दिस वाज लॉन्च्ड. दीज वर द 6 यूटीज वेयर दिस मिशन वाज लॉन्च्ड एज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट. And on 27 September 2021, almost after around 1 year, okay, ek saal se bhi zyada ho gaya in fact, so it was launched in the entire country. So, 27 September 2021, it was launched in the entire nation with these three broad objectives. Number one, to establish a national digital health ecosystem by creating an online platform, number one. Number two, to enable interoperability of health data by creating something like UPI, ठीक है? UPI जैसे हमारा Unified Payment Interface है. Similarly, the National Health Authority is developing Unified Health Interface as well. And finally, to facilitate the delivery of health service throughout the digital health ecosystem, जो कि develop किया जाएगा under this particular mission, All right. Talking more about it. So on 27 September 2021, it was rolled out at national level, as I already told you. Implementing agency for this is National Health Authority. And if I talk about the total budget, so that is rupees 1600 crores for a period of 5 years. All right. 5 saalon ke liye 1600 crore rupees. So that is it. And now let's come back to the question. The correct answer is, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. Okay. This is correct. It was rolled out at national level on 27 September. Ye bhi theek hai. Implementing agency is NHA. This is also correct. Total budget for 5 years is not 2100 crores. It is 1600 crores. So these three are incorrect. This is incorrect. Option D will be the correct answer. All right. Because the first hackathon was organized at Pune, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. ठीक है ना, इसलिए option D हमारा सही answer है. Moving ahead to question number 5. Where has the second meeting of Minister of Industries of Member States of Shanghai Cooperation Organization conducted? कहाँ पे ये meeting conduct हुई थी? And it was attended by Minister of Heavy Industry. Minister of Heavy Industry from India. Now, who is the Minister of Heavy Industries of India? Mr. Mahendranath Pandey. Mahendranath Pandey is the Minister of Heavy Industry. And he attended this second meeting of Minister of Industry of Member States of Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Right? And it was held at Uzbekistan. The correct answer is Uzbekistan. But let's talk more about this news. Remember, during this meeting, the Minister of Heavy Industry, Mr. Mahendranath Pandey, highlighted that India will continue to play an active and positive role in the upliftment of the objective of this organization. And he also reiterated that India is committed to collaborate with industrialists of SCO member countries, so that jo bhi industrial ecosystem hai in member nations ka, usko ek boost diya ja sake. Right? But this is not it. We have to talk about SCO as well. Shanghai Cooperation Organization. What is this? ठीक है, ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन क्या है, हमें इसके बारे में बात करनी पड़ेगी. वन सेकेंड गाइस. ऑलराइट, सो SCO, रिमेंबर, इट इज अ परमानेंट इंटर गवर्नमेंटल इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इट इज अ परमानेंट इंटर गवर्नमेंटल इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. राइट? एंड इट हैज द ऑब्जेक्टिव टू मेंटेन पीस, सिक्योरिटी एंड स्टेबिलिटी इन द रीजन. नाउ विच रीजन? दिस रीजन इज यूरेशिया. बिकॉज इसके मेंबर्स में कुछ कंट्रीज यूरोप के हैं और कुछ कंट्री एशिया के हैं. राइट? वैसे तो यूरेशिया से एक इसमें मेनली रशिया ही है, बाकी तो सारे एशियन कंट्रीज हैं. इट वॉज क्रिएटेड इन 2001. द चार्टर ऑफ इट्स क्रिएशन वॉज साइंड इन द ईयर 2002 एंड इट केम इन टू फोर्स इन द ईयर 2003. डू रिमेंबर दीज थ्री ईयर्स? 2001 में इसको क्रिएट किया गया. द चार्टर वॉज साइंड इन 2002 एंड इट केम इन टू फोर्स इन द ईयर 2003. But before becoming Shanghai Cooperation Organization, it was known as Shanghai 5. ठीक है, इसको पहले क्या बोला जाता था? Shanghai 5. When there were these 5 members, Kazakhstan, China, Kyrgyzstan, Russia and Tajikistan. When it was formed in the year 2001, it was known as Shanghai 5 with these 5 members. और बाद में जब इसके अंदर उज्बेकिस्तान एड हुआ था, after the addition of Uzbekistan to the organization in 2001, it was then named as renamed as Shanghai Cooperation Organization. All right, I hope this is clear. India and Pakistan both joined this organization in the year 2017. On 17 September 2021, Iran ne isko join kar liya. Iran ne announce kiya tha. And currently, Iran is a member. So, how many members are there? Currently, so there are 9 members, which are Kazakhstan, China, Kyrgyzstan, Russia, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, India, Pakistan, and Iran. So these are the 9 members of SCO as of now. So now let's come back to the question. I think I already told you the answer. Answer is Uzbekistan, option E. Moving ahead to question number 6. For which two districts NHPC has signed an MOU for the development of pilot green hydrogen technologies? Pilot green hydrogen technologies ke development ke liye kaun se do district ke saath NHPC ne MOU sign kiya hai? Now remember, these two districts are Leh and Kargil of the Union Territory Ladakh. Leh and Kargil are the name of the district with which NHPC has signed MOUs for development of pilot green hydrogen technologies. ठीक है, नाउ इसकी डिटेल मैंने यहाँ पे पीपीटी में लिख दी है. बट या आई बिलीव इट इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ले. ले के लिए जो एनएचपीसी होगा वो क्या करेगा, इट विल डेवलप पायलट ग्रीन हाइड्रोजन फ्यूल सेल बेस्ड माइक्रो ग्रिड विल बी डेवलप एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस माइक्रो ग्रिड एनएचपीसी गेस्ट हाउस एट निम्मो बैसगो पावर स्टेशन विल बी लाइटेड अप. राइट, सो दिस इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम बट यस फिर भी मैंने लिख दिया है तो आप एक बार रीड आउट कर लेना पीडीएफ में से. द करेक्ट आंसर इज वॉट, लेह एंड कारगिल. बट दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट इन विच टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट फॉर विद विच टू डिस्ट्रिक्ट दिस एमओयू हैज बीन साइन. ये बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, ये आपके एग्जाम में पूछा जा सकता है. इट इज लेह एंड कारगिल. मूविंग अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैज ऑर्गेनाइज द नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन एग्रीकल्चर रूरल डेवलपमेंट बैंक इन न्यू दिल्ली विच वॉज अटेंडेड एज चीफ गेस्ट बाय मिनिस्टर ऑफ कोऑपरेशन मिस्टर अमित शाह. ठीक है जी, सो विच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इट, इट वॉज नेफकार्ड विच इज नेशनल कोऑपरेटिव एग्रीकल्चर एंड रूरल डेवलपमेंट बैंक फेडरेशन लिमिटेड. नाउ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज लोकेटेड इन मुंबई, इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन मुंबई. राइट, एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज टू प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट टू द कोऑपरेटिव्स एज ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड टू help them achieving their goals as the organization. Right? So option A is the correct answer. Question number 8. There is a village which is known as Papan Kui. It has achieved 100% saturation of grey water management. In which state the village is located? Very very important question. ठीक है, बहुत important question है. जल जीवन मिशन से direct आया है ये question. ठीक है, और आपके exam में इसके आने के बहुत सारे chances है. Now this village guys is located in the Kanchipuram district. Now, can you tell me where this Kanchipuram district is? Kanchipuram district कहाँ पे बताओ? Kanchipuram district is in Tamil Nadu. And therefore, the correct answer is option B, Tamil Nadu. Right? Question number 9. Atal Innovation Mission, in collaboration with which of the following institutions has celebrated World Youth Skills Day? Now, there is no need to go into the details of how they celebrated this day. That is not important. Absolutely not important for the exam. Not important, Shodo, it is not at all required, right? Just remember, Atal Innovation Mission has celebrated the World Youth Skill Day in collaboration with CSIR. Option D is the correct answer. And question number 10, the last question for today, name the seminar organized by Minister of Primary Affairs. Who is the minister? Arjun Munda. Arjun Munda's Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti. Khunti is in Jharkhand. And Khunti is the place where the great Birsa Munda born. Ministry of Tribal Affairs at Palghar in Maharashtra to discuss and review the ongoing works on upliftment of tribal communities in the country. And by the way, Birsa Munda was born in Khunti district at a village which is known as Uli Hattu. ठीक है, तो कुछ कोई कुछ लोग कोई offend मत हो जाना, मैंने गलत नहीं बोला है. Khunti district में एक village है Uli Hattu, वहां पे वो actually पैदा हुए थे. So this seminar guys is Manthan. Option C is the correct answer. Alright, option C is the correct answer. This is the seminar which was organized by Ministry of Tribal Affairs to discuss and review the ongoing works on how we are uplifting the tribal communities across the country. Right, option C, Manthan is the correct answer. Okay, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. And I will see you in the next session on Friday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.